Supporting talk. To engage in the practices of the NGSS, the science classroom must become discourse-rich. Sense-making to meet the three-dimensional learning, and in particular, collaborative sense-making, calls for students to engage in talk, and the teacher needs to support that talk. This means major shifts for teachers.
We're finding out that kids, even like really little kids, have like wonderful ideas in science, and that if we stop and like sort of mine their experiences to get at those ideas, it can make science like really, really fun.
How does this look in a classroom?
Maybe there was snow on it.
Who heard what Yadira said? Put your thumb up if you heard what she said. Did you hear what Yadira said? Is there anyone who didn't hear? What about you? Did you hear what she said? Then ask her. Can you say that again?
Can you say that again?
That when a girl or a guy drove something, maybe when they went back somewhere, the wheels that they were using had snow on them.
Take a look at the Three Spheres model from the Framework for K-12 Science Education, written by the National Research Council. The framework is the document that has guided the development process of the NGSS. You see that the inquiry processes are driven by argument, critique, and analysis. These are accomplished in the classroom through social interactions with peers and the teacher.
I like really making the kids listen to each other at the rug, and that has impacted me. And part and parcel of that was how we were not telling them that you are wrong and you are right.
The modifications in blue were made by Dr. Maria Simani, the executive director of the California Science Project and a professor in the Physics and Astronomy Department at the University of California, Riverside. The model shows how social interaction and dialogue is at the center of scientific practices. In other words, social interaction and dialogue drive inquiry and knowledge building in the classroom. The NGSS calls for science to be mediated by productive argumentation, use of evidence, collaboration, and analysis. This can be the most significant shift in practice for a teacher.
So everyone have a little conversation in your groups about what's going to happen when we pour water on the wood chips or the gravel or the concrete, or the grass.
When you look at a classroom that is NGSS aligned, rather than a traditional classroom where the talk is initiated and dominated by the teacher, you notice a lot more discussion with students interacting with each other.
The grass is going to get wet. Grass needs water too, so it can grow.
And then when it grows bigger, you plug it.
Ada, can you talk about how you know it's evidence?
I know it's evidence because you can see water down there.
Because it rains.
The water goes in these two holes, and the holes lead down in the hole that puts water in.
How is talk supported in the classroom? How does the familiarity of the topic, student grouping, teacher responses, the use of home language, and pictures, videos, and real-world artifacts promote talk among students?
What color should we make the concrete?
Gray.
But we use gray for the gravel.
Color piel.
Huh?
Color piel.
Yeah, do we have any color piel?
No.
We found some color piel crayones the other day.
The support of talk occurs in both small and large group.
Imagine you're pouring water on those wood chips. What's going to happen to the water?
It's going to dry.
Right away?
You pour water in them, the color gets like a brownish.
Where will the water go?
Inside.
Do you agree with what Rolando said?
They go inside of the wood chips.
Finally, talk is supported by carefully paying attention to partners and turns in talk, as well as keeping the discussion going by not referring to a right answer.
And instead of supplying them with the right or wrong answer, we're trying to get them to make those connections for themselves.
This was the most difficult transition for Melina.
We're saying, what are your ideas? And then we're seeing all of them as valuable, and we're helping the kids understand that those ideas are actually really wonderful and make a lot of sense.
With the NGSS, teachers are helping students be responsible for each other's ideas. This takes time, and Melina, like all teachers, is developing methods that reinforce the productive talk. What are some strategies you use to help your students listen and respond to each other?